Hello everyone, it's your friendly neighborhood Moshi, and welcome back to another Super Smash Bros. Ultimate Guide. I apologize for the long hiatus that has taken me to get back to work on these guides. Just got back from a little vacation. So, that being said, let's just get right into this guide. Don't want to waste any more time. Today's guide is going to be going over Piranha Plant. The newest addition to the roster will be getting Joker very soon, within the next month. Meant to put out this guide as soon as he came out, but been busy with work and a vacation. Piranha Plant is a very unorthodox character, to say the least. His combo potential is minimal in terms of something that it has that's consistent, something that you could do a lot of the time. But Piranha Plant's not really about the combos. Piranha Plant is about getting those reads and edge guarding. And we'll be discussing how the plant can do that by going over its moveset. I'm going to go over their jab first. Their jab is a simple 1-2-3 hit attack, like most jabs are. They also have a rapid jab that you can perform by tapping the A button, which actually does a decent amount of damage. When you're going to be using the 1-2-3 and the rapid jab, you're usually going to be using early on in order to build up damage. And once you've gotten them around maybe about 20%, I think, that's when you can start going for jab resets. Now onto his tilt. It's tilts. I don't know why I've always called the plant a he, but I'm trying to call it an it, since it technically doesn't have a gender. Plant's down tilt is a very standard down tilt, and one of his key moves links into his forward air very easily, as well as his neutral air, at higher percents. Up tilt is a very good anti-air. It does also have a hitbox next to the plant, as you can see. It's small, but it can hit someone standing next to you. You'll have a harder time hitting shorter characters like Kirby, Pichu, characters like that. Although, Piranha Plant's up tilt does start from behind it, so you could actually do a pivot up tilt by turning around before you use it. You'll have a much easier time hitting it. At the very least, you should. And Piranha Plant's forward tilt is actually a two-stage attack. If you just tap the A button once, you'll just do the first bite, but you have to tap it a second time to the second bite. You can consider it another kind of jab, if you will. Though you're usually not going to be using this like a jab. You'll be using this like most forward tilts will be used in order to force somebody off stage. Piranha Plant's smash attacks are all fairly potent. Forward smash can kill pretty early, like around 70%, usually you'll start taking stocks with this. Maybe even at this percent? Okay, no. So yeah, around 70%, I think, you'll usually be taking stocks with forward smash. Forward smash does have a sweet spot as well. You'll want to hit at the tip of his head. If you just hit with his neck, as you can see, you'll be doing much less damage. So if I set Mario up to, as I said, about 70% near the edge, if you hit the sweet spot, you should be able to take a stock. Yes, easily. If you hit with the neck, though, you won't be taking the stock, so you'll want to make sure that you space this move. Up smash, very good smash attack, and can kill pretty early as well. Has two stages to it, or rather two hits to it, I should say. Piranha Plant will hit once when it's bringing his head up, and then it'll hit a second time at the apex of the attack. Or if somebody's above you, you can just hit them once with it. Down smash, don't really have much to say about down smash. It's a very standard sweep attack. Piranha Plant doesn't have feet. Actually, no, I'm wrong. Piranha Plant does have feet. But it's a pretty standard down smash as far as most down smashes go. And like Mario's down smash and a couple of other down smashes, it's actually stronger on the back swing as opposed to the front swing. So if you hit the back swing with it, congratulations. Now we'll go on to Piranha Plant's aerials. Piranha Plant's neutral air is, I suppose, similar in function to Pikachu and Mewtwo's neutral air. So it's a multi-hitting circular neutral air. It surrounds Piranha Plant completely. You won't really get any combos out of it. It's just a pretty good air-to-air attack or air-to-ground. Now, up air is arguably Piranha Plant's best aerial. Not only can it combo into... First, let me set Mario's percentage back to zero. Not only can it combo into itself in early percents, as well as combo off of Piranha Plant's up throw. Okay, perhaps I was wrong. No, it was Piranha Plant's down throw, my mistake. But it's very good for juggling your opponents. As you can see here, it's not a true combo this early on. Like, if I just keep doing that, it's not a true combo. But if somebody doesn't air dodge, or if you read an air dodge, or if they try and clash with an attack that doesn't come out fast enough, you can just keep juggling them with your up air. And as you can see, you can rack up the damage very quickly. Forward air, it's a very standard just forward attack. You're not really going to... This is mainly Piranha Plant's combo ender off of a down throw. You're not really going to get any combos out of it. Nothing that's true, at least. But it is good for forcing people off stage, or for challenging people in the air when they're trying to come back onto the stage. So it's not a useless aerial at all. It's very good. It's just... Combo potential wise, don't look for anything off it. Like I said, this character really isn't about the combos. This character is mainly just about edge guarding and playing a good neutral game. I guess you could somewhat consider him somewhat like the Pits and Ridley. But again, Piranha Plant is still very unorthodox. So in that aspect, he's not similar to Pit and Ridley. They're very straightforward in what they do. Back air is Piranha Plant's strongest aerial. You'll be taking stocks very early with this. Although you can see it has quite a bit of landing lag, so you can't just toss it out there. Even out of a short hop, you're going to have landing lag. You'll have that landing lag even out of a full hop. But it's still a very good aerial for taking stocks. And if you space it properly, it is safe on shield, depending on who you're fighting. Around this percent, it should be able to, yep, easily kill. So that's forward, up, back, neutral, and last, certainly not least, down air. I love Piranha Plant's down air a lot, actually. It's not as fast as it may look. I believe it comes out in 9 frames, but it's actually very good because you can just run off. If you knock someone off the stage, you actually could just run off and down air. Well, that's a stage spike. I wanted to get an actual spike, but it comes out quickly enough where you can just run off the stage and down air, and sometimes people won't be expecting that. So that's all Piranha Plant's aerials. Oh, I forgot about his dash attack. His dash attack actually is a very good attack. A very good dash attack, specifically, just because it can combo out of his down throw at early percents. No, I'm wrong. No. Is it fourth, though? No. Piranha Plant had an attack that it comboed out of its dash attack, or its dash attack comboed out of. Now I can't remember which attack it was. But nonetheless, Piranha Plant's dash attack is still a good attack to close a distance. It also does cross up on shields, so that's good to know. Was it 4 there? No. Piranha Plant had an attack that comboed out of his dash attack with, but I can't remember which attack it was. Well, anyway, before I get to his special attacks, let's go over his grabs. His down throw is his best throw. You're usually going to be using that to start your combos. It combos into forward air very easily, as you can see. It can also combo into neutral air. It can combo into his up air. I believe if you perform it right, you can combo into his back air. Although you have to build up some percent for that. But you can pretty much combo into any of your aerials out of down throw. The same goes for down tilt. Down tilt can combo into most of Piranha Plant's aerials after you build up some percent. So down tilt and down throw are pretty much your bread and butter combo starters. Against taller characters, you can hit more than one up tilt, or after you've built some percent up on a shorter character. But these combos aren't going to be anything super long or complex. They're basic combos that most anyone with tilts or throws like that can perform. Piranha Plant's forward throw is a very standard forward throw. You'll be using his forward throw a lot more than you think you would to force someone off stage. because forcing someone off stage and beginning the edgeguarding process is where Piranha Plant shines. I say that as I die. Up throw is actually your kill throw. And lightweight's around 140%, actually, you'll begin taking stocks with your up throw. So Piranha Plant doesn't really have a problem taking stocks. All you need to do is get that damage built up, and then send them flying with your up throw. So let's get Mario a bit more damage. Yes, I know I could simply just turn up the damage counter. Alright, so at this point, should be able to just grab an up... Okay, not quite. This health run was around 150%. My mistake. That's when you'll start taking stocks on middleweight characters. So that's down, forward, up. And that just leaves back throw, which is nothing really special. You're just going to be using this to force people off stage. And I guess if somebody happens to miss their tech there... Okay, so now on to the most important part of Piranha Plant, and what makes the plant, is specials. These are what make the Piranha Plant so unorthodox and are the key to playing the plant correctly. First, it's neutral special, Patooey. If you hold down the B button, it'll just keep spewing out that little spike ball. You can push left or right, and it'll shoot out the ball. If a ball is still in play, you'll just get that animation, because you can't have two of them at the same time. As you can see, the ball does quite a bit of damage, and it doesn't go very far unless you throw the ball as it's coming down, like that. Then you can toss the ball almost the entire length of Final Destination. Another thing that you can do is simply just holding the ball like this. As you can also see there, if the Piranha Plant gets hit, the ball will still drop straight down. This is very good against people that like recovering high. So if somebody's trying to get back onto stage and, you know, they use their double jump and then up special to go above instead of going below to grab the ledge, you can edgeguard them that way. Or, most commonly, you can just toss the ball off the stage like that. And you can catch the two frame on the ledge very easily with it. Prime Plant's forward special. First, it's a charging move, so you'll want to get used to that. Your neutral special is not the charging move, it's your forward special. Charging up, it'll gather poison in its mouth, and press forward special again, and it'll let out a poison clap. As you can see, it has no knockback to it whatsoever, but it does a ton of damage if they're just stuck. This also does do damage to shields, and it can break them if somebody's just standing their shield. So with this, you can trap people very efficiently. One thing I like doing is sitting at the ledge after I've gotten somebody forced off stage. I'll just use my forward special in combination with my neutral special, and that makes pretty much this wall of traps that they'll have to get across. Because yes, as I said, the poison cloud may not do any actual damage. No, I'm sorry, I said that backwards. It may not have any actual knockback, but it does a ton of damage. So even if they just roll out into or just get up or use a get up attack, you can threaten them with a grab. And if you grab somebody while they're stuck in the poison cloud, you can see just how much damage you can rack up. Piranha Plant's up special, what I like to call the Rafflecopter, it's actually a pretty good recovery move. And you can carry somebody off the stage easily if you get a little creative with your combos. Well, I missed it there. Piranha Plant can recover from very low with this move as well. The only unfortunate thing is that you cannot cancel this move once it's started. So you're pretty much stuck in it, and you're put into free fall once it ends, so you want to be extremely careful. It's a very good recovery in terms of how much ground it covers, but it does leave Piranha Plant very vulnerable. So don't just throw this out willy-nilly. Mix up your recovery. Oh, speaking of recovery, there's something I forgot to mention about his neutral special. Neutral special does stall Piranha Plant's momentum in the air slightly, so you can use that to mix yourself up as well. I tend to do that from time to time when coming back on the stage. And last, but certainly not least, is Piranha Plant's down special. First, it'll tuck itself away in the pot, and then after a short period of time, it'll lunge out and attack. You can just tap it, and it'll be that little attack, but you usually don't want to do that. You should be charging it. You can angle to the left or right. You can also angle a little bit further, like diagonally downwards if you're in the air. However, once you've turned into a direction, you're stuck going that way. So if I turn left, I can't turn back to the right. There's a couple of interesting things to note about this. First, it can take stocks relatively easily, and again, it's very good for edge guarding. So I could knock Mario off here. And bam, there's his stock. However, Piranha Plant, his hitbox extends with this attack. So you are still extremely susceptible to damage. You have super armor while you're in the pot. But once Piranha Plant lets his stuff out, his hitbox extends with that attack. So that also means that you can be grabbed by tether grabs like Samus and Zero Suit Samus. So, I mean, you could be grabbed by anyone, realistically, if they time it right. So you'll want to be extra careful using your down special. Don't just use it willy-nilly. Somebody can even parry it and then just throw out an attack against you. And that's all of Piranha Plant's moves. So where does the plant excel? As I've said countless times before, it excels at edge guarding. It has no problems forcing people off stage. It has a relatively simple combo game with things like down tilt and down throw into its forward air, neutral air, things like that. And with this poison cloud and spike ball, it has no problems putting people into bad situations when they're trying to come back to the stage. Or trying to come back to the stage, my mistake. So that's going to do it for the Piranha Plant. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Again, I'm sorry it took me so long to get back to doing these guides. I know a bunch of you have had different questions about different characters and such. Once I get through with all of the characters, including Joker, once Joker comes out, I'll be doing a Q&A for any consistent questions that I'm getting, so hopefully I can give you all some answers there. Again, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to hit that like button. Subscribe, because I'm going to start getting back to doing these videos. And I'll see you all next time.